is our honor to introduce the distinguished chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff.
Ladies and gentlemen, General Joseph F. Dunford, Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight and tomorrow, we pause to honor the more than 1 million Americans who have given the last full measure of devotion in service to our nation. They were men and women who embodied our most important values and traditions. They were people who understood what we have in our country is worth fighting for. This year, as we mark the 75th anniversary of D-Day, we're particularly mindful of the more than 4,000 Americans who died on 6 June 1944. They were among the 400,000 fallen in World War II. Since then, we've lost over 100,000 other brave Americans. These statistics are compelling, but they don't begin to capture the enormity of the sacrifice. These statistics represent sons and daughters, brothers and sisters, good friends. These statistics represent children who grew up without their mothers and fathers. These statistics represent lives shattered, hopes and dreams never realized. Tonight, we're also mindful of the men and women who continue to serve. I'd ask you to keep them in your thoughts and prayers as well. On behalf of the Joint Chiefs of Staff and all of our men and women, thank you for remembering. More importantly, thank you for remembering how our men and women lived. And let's also take a moment to remember our Gold Star families and wounded warriors. Please visit our website and learn how you can reach out and make a difference.
Our military serves for us. Now it is our time to serve and support them.
Tonight, we've listened to and been moved by the stories of true American heroes. People from all walks of life who dedicate their lives to fight and sacrifice for their nation. And so it has been throughout our history and every generation.
The members of our armed forces always have and always will continue to inspire the men and women who follow after them. They put their lives on the line every day. When our country calls, they face their fears and rise to the challenge. They stand the watch. I first came to the National Memorial Day concert 2 years ago. I saw firsthand the powerful impact of this show and its meaning to so many. I can't think of anything more personally fulfilling than to be here, which is why it's such an honor for me to be co-hosting alongside Joe.
Thank you again, Mary, for joining us. This is my 18th year here, and it's the most important thing I do every year. And now, with a tribute to all of our military heroes, ladies and gentlemen, the legendary Ms. Patti LaBelle.
Good evening. Thank you, troops. God bless America. As a hero, if you look inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of what you are. There's an answer. You're raging to your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. And then a hero comes along with the strength to carry on, and you cast your fears aside, and you know you can survive. When you feel all hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you finally see the truth that a hero lies in you.
Thank you.
hero that's
thank you, Patty, and thank you all for joining our 30th annual National Memorial Day Concert. Tonight has been about creating a community of remembrance and support that will continue long after these lights go down.
The concert will repeat immediately following this live broadcast on most PBS stations. And now to sing God Bless America, please welcome back Patti LaBelle and our entire cast.
Life.